I like to make a note, this is G. All that is G. G goes to some constant K. So let's use Lagrange multipliers. What's del B? So now when we're starting Lagrange multipliers, the first step, let's get del V, del G, we'll put a lambda with del G. We'll solve the system using the constraint as well. What's the respect to X? YZ, what's the respect to Y? XZ, good job, what's the respect to y, Z? Does that make it this partial derivatives? Okay, that's done. I love this part. What's del G? All right, now put the lambda in front of del G, right? Remember, del G, it's a gradient vector. It's a vector. It's the normal vector. To those contours you saw earlier. I love this. What's this? One, two, three. This is what, this really here is what makes Lagrange multipliers pretty simple. Not every time, I mean it's some nasty systems, but we have technology that can solve crazy systems pretty well. All right, this must equal this. This must equal this. With the lambda, let me put my lambdas. I got the lambda here, I gotta distribute that lambda, right? So I'll put one lambda, two lambda, and three lambda. And x, y must equal this three lambda, and then I'm also gonna write that. So I mean, here's the system we gotta solve. Solve this system, we're going to be done. YZ must equal the lambda. And what else? XZ must equal the?
Two lambda.
Two lambda. And XY must equal the?
Two lambda.
Three lambda. And X plus 2Y plus 3Z. If you're curious why I keep writing and, I mean that's what it's, you've heard the words and, you've heard the words or in mathematics, it's and. When you're talking about a system of equations trying to solve, it's like that equation and that equation and that equation and that equation must hold true for all those variables. Okay, plus another reason I always write that, we used to use a calculator, I see some TI-84s on the tables. We used to use the TI Voyage 200, have you ever heard of it? Feel free to Google it, you'll laugh at what it looks like. It's about this big. It looks like almost like a computer. You know, but that's, the only thing was, it's like the TI-89. In TI-89, you have to type in the word A and B. You had to type A and B. Like when you had to solve the system of equations, you had to go in and go A and D. Then we go off screen, you had to just keep typing all this stuff. Alright. Yeah, let's get started. There's different ways to solve a system. I'm thinking. And when you both have lambdas, you want to set these equal to each other? What would YZ have to equal? YZ equals lambda, then YZ would have to equal what's lambda equal here? X0 or 2? There's one way to start, right? Can I set these two equal to each other if I solve for lambda in each case? That lambda equals YZ. This lambda would equal X0 or 2. Alright, what can I cancel out? The Z's?
Mm-hmm.
What's Y equal to? Right, hey, I'm getting started. Y is equal to x over 2. You know, I could put that over here. So, boy, I'm almost there. When we can get this whole equation in terms of x's, we can solve for it. So I know y is equal to x over 2. That's true in terms of the relationship. Let's play with these two now. Let's play with those two. What would xz over 2 have to equal? Xz over 2 would be lambda. And what would that have to equal? Solve for lambda here. X, y over a 3. What can I cancel out there? If x z over 2 equals x, y over 3, then knock out the x's. Z over 2 must equal what? Y over 3? Ah, so what's z equal to?
2y.
Z equals 2y over 3. I'm getting closer. But everyone, I wanted to get all x's. So any suggestions? Someone's gonna see it. You are the best. I wanna keep y, put that in for the x right there. I'll have that x. But z was in terms of y, she says then just put this right there. So now what z was it? So z now equals, I'm gonna write it again, 2/3 times x over 2. which is now what?
X over 3.
And I'm ready. There's Z. There's Y. Let's put them in here. Right here, I'll just put an F arrow. Here we go. Right here. Let me write this again. X plus 2 times X over 2 plus 3 times X over 3 equals 6. And we'll have X. Now this comes out really easy. This is just what? X plus X plus X? 3X equals 6, right? X equals 2. Got one. So we have X equals 2. That's the length of X. By the way, if I want just to kind of go with this image here, maybe I can call like, you say, well, you got X going this way. Okay, your X equals 2. What's Y though?
1.
How'd you get that Y? You put it right?
Yep, X over 2.
Right there?
Mm-hmm.
So X is 2. 2 over 2 is?
1.
1?
Mm-hmm.
So this Y value is 1. X equals 2. Y equals 1. And how do you get Z?
1/3.
1/3, what'd you use?
X over 3.
Right over here?
Mm-hmm.
X over 3, 1/3. Hey, did I answer the question with the dimensions? Oh, it's 2/3. Thank you so much.
2/3, yes.
2/3. Because right here, X was?
2.
2, so 2 times 1/3 is 2/3. These are the dimensions of the box. They asked for the what? They go, give me the volume, so I'm just going to multiply all these. The volume would be what? 2 times 1 times 2/3 gives me?
4/3.
That would be the maximum volume of a wedge in that box. So there's a funny box in here where the corner hit this plane. And that was a constraint. Cool? Alright, so we're going to use Lagrange multipliers to find the maximum values of the function of x, y, and z subject to constraint g. So I'll start by getting del f. And del f will be just partial respect to x is 2, partial respect to y is 2, and partial respect to z is a 1. And now I'll do lambda del g. And let's see what we get. Here's our constraint right here. The constraint right here is g. So partial respect to x is 2x, partial respect to y is 2y, partial respect to z is 2z. And I will distribute those lambdas to all three parts. So I'll be 2x lambda, 2y lambda, and 2z lambda. So here's the system we got to solve. We're going to solve this system of equations, where 2 equals 2x lambda, 2 equals 2y lambda, and 1 equals 2z lambda. 2 equals 2x lambda, and 2 equals 2y lambda, and 1 equals 2z lambda. One more thing I'm going to write. I'm going to write this constraint down, because that's part of the system we're going to solve. So, and x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 9. So let's see. What is lambda equal to here? Or what is x equal to? We can solve for x, solve for y, solve for z in terms of lambda, and put them all in here. So let's see. What is x equal to? Divide it 2, I get 1 over lambda.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what's y equal to here?
Same, 1 over lambda.
1 over lambda. And what's z equal to?
Half lambda.
Yeah, divide it 2, and the lambda will be in the denominator, right? Like that? Mm-hmm. Is that right? 1 over 2 lambda in the denominator. I'll put them back here right here. So I'm going to substitute all three of these into this. We'll get, okay, 1 over lambda squared plus 1 over lambda squared plus 1 over 2 lambda squared equals 9. I'm going to solve a lambda. So that's 1 over lambda squared plus 1 over lambda squared plus 1 over 4 lambda squared equals 9. Now, how do we solve this? I can multiply 4 lambda squared on both sides.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, if I do that, I get 4 lambda squared
plus 4 lambda squared.
All over lambda squared. Plus 4 lambda squared. I'm just multiplying 4 lambda squared on both sides. Plus 4 lambda squared over 4 lambda squared equals 9 times 4 lambda squared. So what's that come out to be?
Hold on 1 second.
If I do that, what's the left side turn into? That's just multiplying 4 lambda squared.
No, it's 1 lambda squared. 4 lambda squared plus 4 lambda squared plus 1 lambda squared, right?
Oh, so this last part?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me do that. And what I'll do here, in fact, I think an easier way, you're right, Art, I'm thinking an easier way to solve this, in terms of this, I can just do common denominator, right? I think that's easier. I'm going to do that. Multiply 4 over 4, multiply 4 over 4, and that'll be easier than multiplying that LCD on both sides. So now I have 4 plus 4 plus 1 over
9.
So I get 9 over 4 lambda squared. Yeah, I totally agree. That's an easier way to solve this. So I can multiply that up here and divide that, and I got 1 equals 4 lambda squared, right? So let's see. If 1 equals 4 lambda squared, 1 over 4 equals lambda squared, so lambda equals?
Plus or minus half.
Good job. Plus or minus the square root of 1 fourth, which is plus or minus half. So, we're getting two answers. So let's plug them back in. What's one of the answers? If we use lambda equal to a half,
so
we get 1 over 1 half is?
2.
That'll be a 2. 1 over a half is a?
2.
2. And 1 over 2 times a half would just be a?
1.
1. That's one answer. Now, if lambda equals
negative
1 half, right here.
So negative 2.
Negative 2.
Negative 2.
And what's this one?
Negative 1.
Cool. And these are the two points that we're getting. Use Lagrange multipliers to find the maximum values. So how do we know which one gives the max value of f and which gives the min value of f? We just got to plug these back into what?
This
is the last step. We'll just plug these two back into here to see which one gives us the max value and which one gives the minimum value. And obviously, everyone, if we plug in the 2, 2, 1 into this, f is the maximum value of... This gives the maximum value of f to be 2, 4 plus 1 is 9, right? So the max value of f is 9. This point, we plug it in here, gives a number of f equal to negative 9, so this would have to be the absolute minimum value. And this would give us the minimum value of f. There we go. This point gives us the max value of f. This point gives us the minimum value of f. Under that constraint. And that's it.
Alrighty.
Thanks. Thank you for doing it.
Sure.